Hi there, I'm Drew Badger, the founder of EnglishAnyone.com, and it is a pleasure to welcome you to another video. This is another one specifically for new people to my channel. I have over 500 free videos here, and I've been helping people online for, like 10 years, I think, something like that. So I've been teaching for longer than that, but actually on YouTube for that long. And so it's amazing to think, you know, almost a million subscribers at that point, whenever this video is released. But because we have new people joining us all the time, I wanted to answer just a really big question that people have, and that's how to get started, especially if you're learning right here on YouTube. Now, a lot of people, I'm sure you already know lots of English, and that's why you can understand what I'm saying right now, but you struggle to express yourself, and the reason for that is because of how you learned. And it wasn't your fault, it was just that this is how everybody teaches the language. Everybody in regular schools, they're basically trying to tell you that you need to learn English as a second language, and when you think about something as a second language, that means you have to learn it differently. When you learn your native language, you just listen to people speaking and you copy what they do. You see what people say in certain situations and you copy that. Oh, my dad like hurt his thumb and he said, ouch. So whenever I hurt my thumb or I get hurt, I say, ouch also. And this is a funny thing you notice when you're learning a different language. So if I'm, you know, as a Japanese learner, I see someone get hurt and they say, ita, like itai. Meaning something got hurt, like, ouch, that was painful. Ita. I mean, they don't say itai. They say like, ita. Ita. Depending on how painful it was. So I could say, ouch. Or I could say, shit. You know, something that was really painful for me. But when you watch people, what you're really doing as a native speaker, learning a native language, is you're copying that and you're taking the situation and you're connecting it to vocabulary. But what you're doing as a learner of a second language is you're trying to take your language and then connect it with some kind of translation in the language rather than with just the situation. So for me, I think the only person in the world maybe who does not believe in the idea of a second language. I think that's stupid. I think even if it is true that there's such a thing as a second language, you should not be thinking that way about learning, because all that's going to do is tell you, okay, I have to translate and then I have to study grammar rules and I have to do all these other things that don't actually help you learn. So you can study and that will help prepare you for a test, but it's not actually going to help you become a confident speaker. Does that make sense? So all this is just saying it's not your fault. So it's just because of how you learned, but now you have the opportunity to learn and do something different. So if you are here just watching videos, there's lots of great content to learn with. And this is not only people like me that actually help people understand the language, to teach them culture and specific phrases that native speakers use, but also just all the great content on YouTube made for native speakers that I encourage you to watch. So if you like learning about cars or gardening or baking or whatever, even something very specific, some super tiny niche like candle making or how to raise baby rabbits or something like that, there are all kinds of things like that that you could just learn in English and actually learn just a really lot of great information about that. So I learn about things like that in the same way. I watch children's programming for just Japanese kids. And that's how I learned a lot of like songs and grammar and other things like that, just by learning the same way natives do. But I know a lot of people, they come to my channel or other channels here. And right now in 2020, when this video is released, there's so much content available, people might be feeling lost. So if you're struggling to find what should you be focusing on, maybe you're watching more videos on YouTube and you think like, okay, I've just watched 10 videos, but I don't really feel more fluent. I don't actually feel like I'm improving. And it's really important to me and for my channel and for what I do that you should be feeling your improvement with every video. So you should be learning something, either that's teaching you some useful vocabulary or you're changing the way you think. So you think more like a speaker, like a native speaker, and that you're also feeling more confident. So I want you to be listening to these things that I'm saying, but also just like really soaking this in and feeling more confident about learning, because I'm going to give you some direction right now. So right now, again, the YouTube, just it's like an ocean, and you're you're kind of dropping into the middle of that, or even if you've already been watching some useful videos on YouTube, you still might be feeling a little bit maybe confused. What should I be focusing on? Because there's so much information. And so the thing that I can use or try to tell you, this is what I used for myself, but also for my personal students. And this is the idea of the 7 English fluency habits. Now, I mentioned a little bit earlier about the negative habits that you develop because you learn the traditional way in school. So first, we have this idea of a second language, and because of that, you have to learn in a certain way. That means studying grammar rules, translating things in your head, and you're not actually developing fluency. You're really just learning the more formal written English that you would use in a test or in a more professional situation for writing rather than actual conversations with people. So because you learn this way, it creates all these negative habits that actually stop you from speaking. So this is why you think and translate in your head. So we want to correct that. We want to stop those things and replace them with positive habits, with good habits that actually have you just communicating naturally without thinking and getting stuck and losing your words in conversations. So again, there's a really obvious train of how this happened. So a series of events, you had to learn the traditional way that created these negative habits, and that's why you struggle in conversations. So what you have to do now is change the way you learn to actually just recreate or create new habits that help you communicate successfully. So this idea of the 7 English fluency habits, I'm not going to talk about all of them. You can learn more about that on my website and even just other videos. If you type 7 English fluency habits into my YouTube channel, you can learn more about that. But this is basically the idea that fluency is really a collection of habits. So it just means the kind of things that you do automatically without thinking. That's what a habit is. A habit like you get up and brush your teeth the same way every day without thinking about it. That's a habit. Or you walk in the same way. You talk in the same way, that's a habit. And it's difficult for you to try to change that and develop a different habit. So this is what we help people do in programs like the Fluency Course. We get you really excited early by teaching you a lot of useful vocabulary, but also take time to develop your habits by changing the way you learn. So what I'd like you to do is focus on your weakest fluency habit. So this could be something like your use of grammar, or it could be your vocabulary, or it could be your listening. It could be any of these different things. So the 7 different things. And again, I talk more about those at my website, EnglishAnyone.com. But if you want to just think about the easiest way to understand that is to think about what you're struggling with the most. So if you know a lot of words already, you probably don't need to learn more vocabulary to become a better speaker. You should probably be thinking about your confidence or your listening or your grammar or your pronunciation. There are a couple different things you can focus on, but you probably know already when you're in a conversation, what do you feel the least confident about? So if it's your pronunciation, then that's probably the thing you should be focusing on first. So don't spend your time watching just videos about more vocabulary, because you don't need more vocabulary. You need videos specifically about pronunciation. So whether it's me or someone else, or you even just like watching movies or clips of your favorite actors or actresses talking in a certain way so you can copy their pronunciation, that's the thing that you should be focused on right now. So I know it can be every day, because there's so much content for people to learn with, it can be really just daunting. This is another great word, daunting, D-A-U-N-T-I-N-G, daunting. So it can be daunting to think about, wow, there's so much content here. How do I learn with this, especially without getting lost or feeling like you're wasting your time? So think about the thing that you struggle with the most and then look for content specifically about that. I cover all these different things on my channel right here on YouTube, and especially the other programs that we offer at EnglishAnyone.com. But you can learn more about any of these things and just find someone that you enjoy learning with, or find some kind of content, whether it's learning actually with a teacher or someone who can just enjoy talking about, whatever that content is. So if they like making kites and you want to learn more about that, then do that. But the thing you should be focusing on, really the next step you should be taking right now, is thinking about what you struggle with the most, because that's what's going to get you faster, fastest to fluency. Really, the weakest thing that you struggle with, it's like a chain with multiple links in it. And the chain is a great English expression. You probably have something similar in your native language, but the chain is only as strong as its weakest link. So if the other links in the chain are very strong, if that one little weak chain link is really weak and it breaks easily, then the whole chain breaks. So again, you have to think about what are the things that you really struggle with the most, whether it's your pronunciation, your grammar, listening, that kind of thing. Think about that and then look for information about that specific thing. But that's going to make you feel a lot more confident because you've got some direction. It's what you should be doing next right here on YouTube or however else you like to learn. Well, that's it for me. Hopefully, I didn't give you too much information. Again, you can learn more about me and what I do at EnglishAnyone.com. You can also click on the link in the upper right of this video to learn more about the Fluency course. This is our number one best-selling and really longest-running program where we teach people to speak conversational English confidently. So you can learn lots of great expressions and vocabulary, learn how to improve your pronunciation, your listening so you understand native speakers, and also build the confidence and fluency to have great conversations. So if you'd like to learn more about that, click on the link in the upper right of this video or on the link in the description below this video. Well, that's it for me. The last thing I'd like to say is, if you want to continue learning right here on YouTube, do these three simple things right now. 1. Click on this link to subscribe to my YouTube channel for over 500 free videos. 2. Click on this link to download my number one ebook guide to fast fluency free. And 3. Click here to watch the most popular video on English fluency here on YouTube.